So I got them, and then I kind of, it was a weird time in my life, and I got them together, and then I was ready to send, and they were dead. This song somehow turned into like meow, 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 like the cat commercials. But I originally had written it the way we're going to do this now. And the night my dad died, I was in Whitefish. And I was with my friend Patrick Kenny. Patrick's the guy that turned me to Mount Everest, thinking, I don't know, great way to kick heroin. We're just going to fucking go to 19,000 feet. I'm not so sure that I would suggest that as a way to kick, but by the time you got to 19,000 feet, you were pretty clean, and coming back down, I came down alone, and it felt pretty good. Patrick had summited a couple times. So he was with me, and we played this thing. Weirdly, we ended that night with The Vessel Fall from Grace of God. I get this call. My dad's dead, and I can't get a flight out of anything close. Not out of Kalispell or Missoula. I had a show that night in Bozeman, so this is the next night. And it was a flight, and Patrick said, you gotta play the show. I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about? I'm like, my dad's on a slab at LAX, and my mom, and I'm like, I gotta go home. He's like, okay, so you get the 8 o'clock flight and be at LAX at 11? Actually, I didn't know this all day, at midnight. Your mom will be heavily medicated and asleep. Or you can get the 6 o'clock in the morning flight and you can play the show. And he goes, you will fucking regret it for the rest of your life if you don't play. So I did. And when I got to LA, the other thing was that Terry, my wife, and myself had just had a baby, so this brand new baby boy. And I had 3 hours of musical catharsis, and everybody else was like, you're not grieving the same. You know, man, even better, we lived in Harlem, and I went to, had to get a mass and a baptism. Mass for my dad, baptism for my son, and the priest there, Father Kelly, the most wretched fucking orator that I've ever met in my life, and he walks in, he looks at me and goes, Mr. Joseph, somebody had a baby. Congratulations. And he looks back down and goes, well, your dad died. And I'm like, yeah. And he goes, I said, you do this kind of circle thing. And he goes, oh, yeah. He goes, it's a big circle. He goes, people get on, people get off. He goes, that's why I have a job. He goes, let's do it on the same day. And it's called Light as Like Water. Yeah. the sea is shallow, yeah. I do not know them, but I sure it's just as well. Though I would gladly share my juice, my coffee, my rings, my girlfriend, and my conversation. I keep my distance and my opinions to myself. It ain't your story, how to say. But bees didn't know me, but the cold sea is singing in on me. And they said drowning in the desert, the cool Pacific Ocean is for fools, for prophets who can't see. And baby, love. Thank you. when I die. For in the hands of my new companion, I will cross over the land of my fathers in the sky. This is another song from this new record, sticking with the marriage thing. except I was in Northern Iraq. There was a massive cities, Erbil and Dohuk and Sulaymaniyah, and then you read about Mosul. It's important to remember that those cities were taken by about 4,000 ISIS guys. They're pretty fierce fighters. The Peshmerga Kurdish guys that I know were fighting them. They're like fucking lunatics, but they don't run. But we always kept talking about how there's a number of American cities that are surrounded by right-wing racist militias, and Portland is the jewel of that. It's everything that the American right hates, and it's surrounded by these motherfuckers anywhere you look. And they're heavily armed. You know, Bush gave all of the surplus military weapons to the sheriff's departments and stuff like that. You know what I mean? Armored troop carriers. Anyways, I'm only bringing that up because it reminds me of Iraq. And I'm like, oh, it's a big, massive city. Who the fuck is going to take this city? Like, bam, you know, it's gone. No fucking idea what song is. I mean, Michele. So if you go to Sulaymaniyah, there are these three towers. They're 23 stories, and you see this a lot in parts of the third world, the places that have war. And they're not finished, but me and my friend Charlie Freeman were referred to them as the bone towers. They look like skeletons, and you can see them from all over the city, and that's how we figure out how to get back to where we were. So the song, this is called Bone Towers. It was the hardest song for me to record on this record because Patterson wouldn't let me go up with my voice. And I spent so much time trying to go, if I could spend a lifetime screaming. And we had to cut the whole track with me down here. So,
all right. Good job.
I just wanted you to know that. What? Yes, it's amazing. But it was, yeah, he's amazing. But that was the hardest thing. And then there's this one line about coyotes and hyenas and the record that don't go up. But I fucking wrote it. I don't know if I can sing it up.